What's up, fishing addicts? I was just looking through my stuff. I'm packing some of my gear, winterizing it and sorting it out. And I was thinking, the other day I went fishing and I was going over my head what was going on. When I got there mid a little bit late afternoon, around 4:15, I was throwing a fluke. To be exact, double fluke rig, weighted one. Looks like this. I made a video a bit about it, and I was catching well, I was getting basically a lot of numbers, but nothing big. And what happened was, once the sun went down, I wasn't getting any bites on the double fluke rig. And here's some of the catches. Want to put it over here. And once it got dark, I wasn't getting any bites. And I tied on a jerk bait. Actually, I tied one of these. This is from Baker Lures. It's a holographic jerk bait. And I made a couple of casts, sure thing. Within my fourth cast, I hooked onto a nice walleye. I believe it was 24 and a half inches. And my PB, by the way. And I was pretty excited, so I started fishing it more aggressively. What ended up happening is I started getting hung up, and I lost four jerkbaits within maybe 20 minutes. And at the end, I called it a day because I just was half of my tackle right there. So when I was packing, I start thinking through it, like, how can I combine this and this? So, and I was going through my jig box, and I came across these bad boys. I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to see them. But these are bullet weights with the rattle. So what I was thinking, that's right, you guessed it, double fluke rig with rattles. So I would avoid getting hung up, and I'll still be able to just use it like a jerk bait, and it's weighted so I can fish it in a deeper water. So basically something like this, but it has rattles, so I can. You can cast it, wait a couple of seconds. You don't have to wait that long, depending on how deep you are fishing. The deepest part I'll probably on Fox River by me that I can fish, it's probably like 8 to 9 feet. And most of the time I'm fishing 4 to 6 feet of water. So a cast, 2 3 seconds, and jerk jerk stop, jerk jerk stop, and this will do great. So let's I got my hooks. I already tied them on, and I believe this is 14, no, this is 15 pound fluorocarbon. I like to use during the late fall and winter and early spring. The water in the river gets pretty clean, so I like to use fluorocarbon. And let's see what we're gonna do first. We're just gonna put a bead. That's for the weight, so it doesn't damage the knot. And I'm gonna put the bullet weight so it stays in. Make a good knot. Yes, okay. Stay in. And then we're gonna put a bobber stopper. So everything is pretty much the same. Just like a double fluke rig, donkey rig, Zulu rig, whatever you guys call it in your part of the country. voila. And every time you jerk it, just like a jerk, but it has a rattle. And since we're using a fluke, it will be weedless, just like this one. Completely weedless. So even if this falls on the rocks, every time you pop it, it's not gonna get hung up that much. Let me say that. It does sometimes get hung up, but you can just pop it. It's pretty easy. And let me tie this one. And you need two swivels. The reason you need the swivels is simply because to reduce line twist. Line twist is a big factor. I'm gonna do a, I'm not sure what the knot is called. It's like a, almost like a polymer and uni knot. So it's basically both of them combined together. And my hands are pretty oily from the young baits. Just do this couple of turns then. Usually when I have a 12-pound fluro, I'll do 6 to 8 turns, but when I have 15, I can get away with 4. So like I said, basically like a polymer. And you need not just wet the line, pull it through. You don't have to pull that hard, just snug them in and cut the tag in. Actually, I made it a little bit longer than I wanted, but it's all right. We'll have it do. Or yeah, I think this is too long, but whatever, 2 feet, it's fine. And what you want to do with this one is going to be the short one. So what you want to do is slide it to your main line. I couldn't get to get in the hole. So once you slide it, grab your second swivel, and again, I'll do a advanced polymer or hybrid polymer uni knot. And if you want to know how it's tied on, like I said, I'm not quite sure what the name is, the exact name for it is, but if you want, I can make a video about it. Just post it down in the comments. And usually if you're using a braid for a main line, 3-4 turns will be enough, but I'm using a monotex, which is a hybrid between a monofilament and braid. So I make 6 to 8 turns on it. It's, the line is a little bit slippery. And just pull it in a little bit. Once it's even, wet the line. I know it's not fluoro or mono, but with gliss, I don't want to take chances. Not a big, actually I do like the line. This is 24 pounds, and I think it's like thick as a 4 pound 4 pound test mono or fluoro. It's extremely thin. And let's have second one. Where you at? There go. Same thing. Put we'll put the bead in to protect our knot. Then we'll put our rattling bullet weight. I got these from Bass Pro. I forgot how much they were, but they were pretty cheap. I was looking for tungsten, and they were cheaper than tungsten, so I bought them. And at the time, I didn't know they had rattles. Slide it down through your line. Boom, done. And the reason instead of using a smaller fluke like this one, like Fluke Junior, I'll be using actually the full-size flukes. The reason being, like I said, the walleye I caught, it had I would say like close to 6 6.5 inch shad in his mouth. So winter time, instead of going for numbers, I rather try to catch a trophy, to be honest with you guys. So we're gonna make this one a little bit shorter. So one of them, what I like to do is most of the time, let's measure now. Right about there. What you want to do is make one of them about 3 inches shorter. It's a long tagging. So on this one, I'm gonna tie actually a uni knot. I'll just make maybe like I made like 8 to 9 turns. Come on. I don't have my contacts, so some of the stuff, it's a little bit fuzzy. Get the line wet. I do not like this uni knot thing. It doesn't work that well for me. Just to make sure we didn't burn the line, it's pretty nice and tight. Cut the tag in. Voila. Now, and once you cast these, they do not tangle themselves. So don't worry about them being getting tangled or whatever. It's like I said, I've been using this since last year. It's a great, a fun way to catch bass. I mean, give it a try. I do encourage it. Double checking. And like I said, I don't know if you guys can see it, the different height. One of them is gonna be just a couple inches shorter than the other one. So, and like I said, I will be putting full size flukes on these, which I have. Well, I bought two different ones. I bought the Hundi Shad from Yum, black and silver, and I bought Hundi Shad. This one is with gold flake. So I'll try both of them, see how it works. Last year I did a experiment on big and small. I did catch fish on both of them, so at times fish want a snack, at times they want a one meal, so they don't have to look for a fish for a meal all day long. I'm not gonna hook it up right now, since I'm not going fishing today or tomorrow. I'll go fishing Tuesday or when it's not raining. I was supposed to go this morning, but it was raining like crazy. So that said, let me know what you guys think about this setup. You think it's gonna be a good setup or bad setup? And let me know if you're willing to try it out. And I hope you guys enjoy the video. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe and hit that like button. I will catch you guys on the next one.